Evernote have had a pretty tumultuous time over the last couple of years, with huge pricing increases and a new free plan that has got a lot of people scared. Many people are looking to see whether they should leave Evernote in 2024 or whether they should stay with Evernote. With the rising options of note-taking applications in the market, it can be super difficult to ignore them as innovations continue to flourish and AI continues to build new ways to use note-taking applications. So it makes it even harder whether you should stick with an application like Evernote or whether you should seek new pastures green. Today's video, we are going to break everything you need to know about whether you should leave Evernote or stay with Evernote in a comprehensive guide to that. Many people have stayed with Evernote for many years, and it's really important to make an informed decision. So we're going to do that in today's video. Hello everyone, my name is Francesco. If you're new here, we are Keep Productive. We help you to find productivity tools, but we also help you with productivity tips and advice in general for work and life. So if you're new here, hit the subscribe button down below. And if you do enjoy this video, you find it useful near the end, do like it because it means it gets shared with many other people. Whilst in this video near the end, we're going to give some tips to picking Evernote alternatives. We're actually not going to cover specific Evernote alternatives, although throwing the odd loose name out there. If you are looking for Evernote alternatives, we've made a pretty decent in-depth guide that is available in the description below. You can find Evernote alternatives there, as well as hundreds of other note-taking applications on ToolFinder. Now, leaving is not just the regular decision for an Evernote user. It's actually a big one. Evernote have built a brand with many users from 2011, typically when a lot of people joined, and that brand has introduced them to not just Evernote software that you see on screen, but products like the Moleskine notebook and many more that they even may carry around today. So that decision comes from the heart. And I know, as somebody who has been a big time Evernote fan in the past, that decision is not going to come lightly. So leaving Evernote is not just a one layered decision, it's a multifaceted one. And when it comes to pulling the heartstrings, it definitely can make it more difficult. So let's look at the first element of this, budget. I think budget is something that a lot of people forget with personal productivity. Sometimes it's really important to keep within your budget. And for some people that might be $50 a year, and for other people it might be $200 a year. It really depends on your situation. And budget is really fundamental when it comes to choosing a productivity application. And one of those things that happened with Evernote recently is that the free plan has become a lot less free. The limitations are now 50 notes and one notebook, and of course you have the regular syncing issues where you can only sync two devices. So a lot of people are actually considering, now that they've got 1,000 notes in Evernote over the years, 3,000 notes in Evernote, should I move because I'm not able to add new notes to my Evernote account if I don't pay the premium pricing, which is now $14.99 if you don't consider the typical 40% off you typically get. This is really important to note because budget is something that is very important when choosing a note-taking application. It's going to store your notes, so in a way, you might have allocated some budget towards it, but it's important that it meets it. Obviously, there's a dramatic cost that is increasing across the market, but it's something to note when you're looking at a note-taking application. If you were to, say, look at an alternative like Obsidian, then it's going to be free. But if you wanted some of the syncing abilities in Obsidian, I believe the price is $7.99. So again, you're still in that remit of pricing that you typically might need to know when looking at alternatives. So be cautious with the pricing options. I'd recommend taking a look at what other options are in the market. I think what you're typically going to get is between $5 to $10 for what you need as a replacement, and then there's going to be ones that are between $10 to $20, which are a bit more premium. And I think that's where the market's going to be heading, much more premium and much more intensive pricing option. So next up is the innovation side of stuff. And a lot of people might be considering moving from Evernote because the innovation has been lacking over the last couple of years. And that's very true. Actually, the new Evernote team have been investing a lot on the infrastructure side and rebuilding it to their standards and their specifications. So of course, Evernote really haven't been putting their foot down on dramatic innovations, although they have had elements like note cleanup and the ability to use AI search. But in terms of what the market is now offering with PKM tools that have canvas abilities and newer AI functionality that is much more generative, this is actually something that a lot of people are considering above likes of Evernote. So if innovation is one of your things that you are moving for, I would also take this with a pinch of salt, primarily because innovations are moving quite fast at the moment. Specifically with AI, innovations are actually becoming very rapidly adopted because the technology is becoming a lot easier to understand and implement. But what I would say is if you are looking at alternatives that have a completely different spin on Evernote, then innovations in those aspects are totally okay. For example, if you're one person is a visual thinker and you're looking at apps like Heptabase as your note-taking app alternative, then do consider that, because then obviously you're thinking about changing the way you note-take. But it's really important that you look at the foundations of your productivity when doing so. Next up is probably the most important factor, moving tax. And what I mean about that is just the activation of moving all of your notes to another application. This is really important, and when considering leaving Evernote, your alternatives really need to have a switching experience, which allows you to move your notes from Evernote over to the new application. Now, a lot of these do. Obsidian more recently upgraded theirs, made it much better. But it's really important to note that these applications don't always work well with each other, and moving from Evernote can actually become a difficult one. So make sure you do a little bit of inside research into which one has that, our alternatives list had a breakdown, and which ones have an official and non-official switcher. But this is really important because you may be transferring 3,000 notes in a day, and making sure that you're aware of that is really important. And the actual time it takes you to do that and the stress it takes you can also be a factor and have its own price nominated to it. Okay, so now the difficult one. Should I stay with Evernote in 2024?
Don't let me leave, Murph!
Now, this is probably one of the things that a lot of people don't understand on the channel, because we talk about different aspects of productivity, but we also have an opinion, but we share both sides of it. Now, Bending Spoons have acquired a lot of software companies, and they've done very well rapidly growing them. And I don't have that doubt with Evernote. Just because of the situation with the market, I actually think that probably in about 3 years, Evernote will be a much more mainstream Apple-promoted, Apple-adopted application that will appeal to the different type of user, not the regular Evernote Joes that have been in the past. I definitely think that Bending Spoons has the capabilities and leadership to do that. And whilst I have a very a loose relationship with them in terms of keeping updated with press releases and things like that, I definitely think whilst they're not community focused, I do think they'll be able to produce interesting products in the future. Now, there are sort of two elements to this. The infrastructure side of stuff that they've been focusing quite heavily on recently is changing a lot of the core foundations of Evernote. And for somebody looking to stay, this is quite an important thing, because we have typically been used to Evernote in the last 4 or 5 years being a little bit flaky. And I think we're going to see some pretty standardized structures to Evernote that allow you to use it much more consistently and reliably, which is what Bending Spoons typically does well. That sort of infrastructure as well leads on to their fast nature in developing new features, which I think will probably be one of their top priorities for 2024. They actually released in their outline for this year that whilst they covered loads of infrastructure stuff in January, I believe it was, or Q1 at least, they are planning to release a new design to Evernote. So that's something that users probably can expect to see in the near future. They are also one of the biggest innovators in AI technologies. Whilst there are many different companies that are using ChatGPT wrappers, this company has actually got solid foundations in AI and a set of investors that are actually pretty well aware of the future of AI as well. So if you're looking to stay, it really has to be for the potential that Bending Spoons holds, and also the awareness that the market might change as well with subscription pricing. I think those are the two factors that if you are an Evernote user and you are still on the line on whether to switch over to another application, those are probably the two surviving hopes for you left. So let's talk a little bit about alternatives. A lot of people might be making the move to another application, and that's totally fine. I would say there's probably three types of applications that you need to consider with Evernote, and they are heavier, lighter, and hybrid. Heavier applications are applications that are more PKM based, that have bidirectional links, graph functionality, and more, and typically allow you to do a lot more in the application in terms of bringing notes together, resurfacing them. And there are a lot of these different applications on the market. I typically call them PKMs. A lot of people call them PKMs as well. But the application, in a sense, needs a little bit of education to use. And I think a lot of people will move over to these applications. They don't typically transfer well with what you may have been doing with Evernote, but at the same time, it's a well worth consideration. Later note-taking applications might be the likes of UpNote, Bear Notes, etc., that provide you with more markdown, raw abilities, but with lighter notes in mind. And for many people moving note-taking applications, this can be a big switch over to a lighter, more easier system to use in the future. And hybrid, many people might be considering combining notes with tasks, notes with calendar, with apps like Agenda Notes, and maybe even the likes of NotePlan, etc., etc. But hybrid is definitely a consideration for many people that have stuck with Evernote for just one thing. The change of pricing may spark their interest in combining one or two of their productivity applications in the future. So I hope this was a comprehensive guide to making a decision on moving or leaving or staying with Evernote in 2024. And I hope it gave you some insights. As I said, there is a full in-depth guide to which alternatives are best and we typically recommend here on Keep Productive. You'll find that linked below. And you can also find insights on Toolfinder into the best note-taking applications. So thank you very much, folks. I hope you enjoyed today's video and found it useful. Hope it wasn't too sad for you. We'll be back with another video very soon. So if you're new to the channel, please do make sure to subscribe and like the video if you enjoyed it, so it gets shared around to everyone else who may be in the same situation. So folks, I will see you very soon. Thank you very much. And I hope you enjoy more videos here on the channel.